which substitute pair has impressed you guys the more? That is it Vidhiman Shah and David Warner or Ishan Kishan? Or
no, wrong way. When you talk about Kohli's captaincy or Warner's captaincy, we just took it in a wrong way that he's got attitude, he's speaking so much, he's loud-mouthed. But I think they walk the talk as well. I think you have to see the kind of passion they have when they're leading.
Really glad that he got to play at the top of the order, and I'm also glad to see someone like Ishan doing more justice to his potential by applying himself better according to the situation and showing restraint and mixing caution with aggression, basically controlled aggression.
Can RCB come back stronger from a series of losses? Can Sunrisers Hyderabad continue with the winning momentum? We have got two new special appearances over here, and all for the playoffs. Well, I'm Arijit Kundu, and you're watching What's Up IPL, a weekly analysis of the biggest festival of the tournament by cricketers and experts from the cricketing world. Like, share, and subscribe, and yeah, stay tuned.
Hey guys, hello everybody, and welcome back to Cricket Tribune, and welcome back to the sixth episode of What's Up IPL. Well, it's a playoffs time for IPL right now, and we have got two guests over here, and very, very special ones. Well, we have to get a special one because it's a special time for IPL too, isn't it? So, one hand, we have got Abhishek Raman, the opening southpaw of Bengal cricket team. He has also represented the India Blues and also the India A. And on the other hand, we have got Hrithik Roy Chaudhary. You know, he's also a promising middle-order batsman for Bengal and has also represented India under 23. So Abhishek da, Hrithik da, how are you? How you all are doing?
Hey, Raman, go first.
Yeah, I'm doing great. It's been a good time watching the IPL. So I'm having a great time right now.
All right. And Hrithik da, what about you?
All good. Exciting, festive season, IPL, India festive season plus cricket festival. So all exciting times. You know, the winter is coming. Everyone's looking forward to so many things amidst a pandemic. So yes, we all should consider ourselves fortunate. And that's about it. Let's talk some cricket. All set.
Yeah, absolutely. And all of you guys who are listening to me, if you haven't yet subscribed to my channel Cricket Tribune, make sure you do, because there are gonna be a hell lot of things coming up very, very next. And yeah, starting off with the playoffs of IPL, speaking about the team which is at the bottom when considered about the top four, in the table, that is Royal Challengers Bangalore. And speaking about them, first of all, I would love to say that your teammate Shahbaz Ahmed, how impressive was he, Abhishek da? Shahbaz, you all have played with him, and look, how impressive was he in the last game, taking two crucial wickets?
He was very impressive, to be honest. We all know he's very good with the bat, but he's proving himself with the ball as well. I think we know we have kind of capability he has as an all-rounder. He showed it for Bengal as well. So I was pretty optimistic when he was playing the game, because the wicket was also suitable for him. It was turning a bit, it was holding onto the pitch. And he's a smart bowler, we all know that. And I think he's a very good buy for Bangalore, because he acts with the batting as well. And he's a very good fielder, which we have seen throughout the IPL, yeah. The couple of games he has played. He has chipped in with a good catch, couple of wickets. He's good in the field. So I think he will be a very good asset for Bangalore in the coming games as well, as the wear and tear has started to happen in the Dubai pitches and the Abu Dhabi pitches. So I feel he will be doing the job for the RCB in the middle overs.
Yeah, Hrithik da, what about you? Have Shahbaz plumbed you anytime in the nets? Just the way he
actually did it. I remember. I actually play him pretty well. So okay. You can ask him that later. I enjoy facing him. But as Raman rightly said, Shahbaz is a very smart cricketer overall, especially with the ball. He might seem innocuous, but he's got very good control. He's got slight variations. The wear and tear towards the end of the IPL, the pitches also will be suitable for spinners. And anyway, whatever the conditions, he adapts really well. He's a very good batsman also, like Raman said. But overall, he is just a very complete cricketer. He gives the luxury of whichever team he's playing for. He's like two players in one. Good batsman, good bowler. He's good on the field also. So it's very, for any team that he plays, he will be an asset. He's a true three-dimensional cricketer, if you ask me. And fantastic attitude, always very positive and, dumb se khelta type guy. And he puts it, leaves everything on the field. You would really love to have a guy like him on your team. So, best wishes always with him. And proud that one of our young teammates is, making his presence felt in the IPL.
And when you mentioned about dumb se khelta, you know, it made me remember of the catch he took in the first game he played. And after taking the catch, he was like this. Oh man. So there's something which resembles your words too. Well, anyways, coming to Royal Challengers Bangalore once again, coming from four back-to-back defeats, Abhishekda, what do you think that what kind of motivation can they bring on in the playoffs? You know, because coming off from four defeats, you know, and then straight away into the playoffs, they really require some motivation, if I feel.
See, the motivation is always going to be there because they are playing the playoffs. It doesn't matter that they're coming after a fourth consecutive defeat. It's gone. It's done and dusted. So it's not something which is really going to matter to them. Yeah, they have the likes of Virat Kohli and AB de Villiers, who have played so many big games in their lifespan. So I think they don't need motivation. They know what's up for the grabs. They know the importance of a qualifier game. If they win this, they have a big chance, they have a big shot to nearly go for the title. But I think as a team, I'm not thinking that they're very much balanced right now, especially in the batting department. But definitely they have the two match winners in the team, which Virat Kohli and AB de Villiers. So they have all the chances in the world. But I just feel if AB and Virat doesn't fire, it is going to be difficult for RCB. And they know that because their middle order hasn't fired at all. And Partikel has them given the starts, but it's up to AB de Villiers to do the, you know, the late magic every time to get them through. So I think they are dependent too much on these two. Let's hope for the best that these two fire and take the RCB past the line.
Yeah. And Abhishek, now coming to RCB's bowling attack, you know, we have seen Isuru Udana, you know, hasn't been that good in the last few games. You know, in the beginning, he was very, very good. You know, he was doing good. And speaking about, we have also seen that the RCB, the lower middle order, you know, that is after the number 5. At number 5, I keep Shivam Dubey over there. So, do you want to see someone like a Moeen Ali coming up there, or you know, do you want to see someone like a Dale Steyn, you know, coming up and performing in a big match? Because we know he's a big match player. Let's just forget about his performance this year. And I will, but no doubt, you know, experience always works on big match games. What are your thoughts, Abhishekda?
See, first of all, I agree to you that Udana hasn't been the greatest pick in the playing 11. If you ask me, personally. He just brings in the left-arm pacer at a dimension, different dimension, but he hasn't been a proven customer in the IPL till now. And I feel like Moeen Ali will be a better bet to play in the playing 11 because he adds the balance, because they don't have an off-spinner in their ranks. Yeah, I know, they have Washington in their ranks. But he can get it to a 2-3 overs in the middle as well, and he can bat in the lower middle order, and he can really, really score quickly. And we all know how effective his bat with the middle order for England. He has done it for England, he has done it for the county sides he has played. We have seen how destructive he is in the middle order. And they need a batsman like him in the middle order who can come in and start playing shots from ball one. I think they're too much dependent on AB de Villiers, and I think Moeen Ali is the only guy in their ranks right now who can really bring in the balance which they really require. And I think the wickets are also helping the spinners. So you have to bring in someone who can bowl, chip in with a few overs. And they have the likes of Navdeep Saini to play if they want to change Isuru Udana. So I think they can go for that kind of a change. It can be a straight swap between them.
Yeah, Vithikda, what do you think? You know, what are your views? You know, do you want to see a Dale Steyn or a Moeen Ali in place of Udana?
Yes, I can agree with Moeen Ali playing, especially with the pitches slowing down, and he's a very high utility cricketer, you know, with both bat and ball. So yeah, it really depends on what they feel about the conditions. As long as dew is not too much of a factor, if you're bowling second in Abu Dhabi or Dubai, I think a spinner will be helpful. And Navdeep Saini, as Raman said, is available if you want to play in place of Udana. So it really depends on how they gauge the conditions and you know, strike the balance between batting and bowling, because you don't want to be heavily dependent on one or two people in a knockout game. So it will be interesting to see what combination they play. They have their options, and they've played well. They've played some good cricket. Let's forget about even the last four games. It's not like they haven't been competitive in all the games. Yeah. They've been there. They had their chances. The dew can be a factor when you're defending a total in these night games or evening games. So it will be interesting and to see what combination they decide with. But the good thing is they have their options, their players have chipped in and contributed, but it's towards the business end, you know, when there is a knockout game, you have to, you know, go in with your best 11, whatever you feel. So, as I said, whatever they decide to do, it will be, I guess, a lot of thinking will go into it. So let's see what they do. Moeen Ali, as Raman said, would add a lot of value to the team, no doubt about that. But not too sure about Dale Steyn at the moment. You can't take away anything from the cricketer he has been for RCB and South Africa. So, but yeah, I don't think they'll be selecting Dale Steyn in the playing 11. But if they do, by any chance, you know, his experience will come in handy and absolutely priceless, actually. So, let's see how they do. I mean, options are plenty. Depends on the think tank of the team.
Absolutely. Coming to the Sunrisers Hyderabad right now, you know, back-to-back, a hat-trick of wins and into the playoffs, you know, knocking off the Kolkata Knight Riders, Rajasthan Royals and Kings XI Punjab, you know, they had a bit of luck on their side, on the head, especially Kings XI. Sunrisers Hyderabad, their top four has been top-notch, you know, speaking about Ridhiman Shah, David Warner, Manish Pandey and Kane Williamson, I see no changes there. But at the number 5 and 6, you know, it has always shuffled between Priyam Garg and Abhishek Sharma and Abdul Samad. So, Abhishek, what do you think, you know, which are the two that Sunrisers Hyderabad should pick for the number 5 and 6?
See, I feel the Vijayashankar was doing a really good job at 5 or 6. Yep. I thought, I don't know if he got an injury or not.
He was injured. That's the reason.
Yeah, if he's injured, I think they need to go with someone like a Priyam Garg, because he's a proper batsman. I know Abhishek Sharma can give you a couple of overs, but they already have Nadeem in their ranks, who is doing a good job. And I think instead of taking bits and pieces players, I'm not undermining the capability of Abhishek Sharma, but I feel that Priyam Garg is a proper batsman who can come in and play. He has won a game for them as well in the middle order. So I think he has the capability, but it's going to be difficult because he's pretty young. And in big games like these, you need players who have experience in their side. And unluckily for Sunrisers, the middle order has been pretty shaky. And that's why they have to play Kane Williamson instead of Bairstow, because their middle order doesn't have that kind of a depth. So I feel that they can even go for Nabi, because the kind of experience he has, he bats well in the middle order. He's a proven customer for SRS. Whenever given a chance, he has proven his capability. I know Kane Williamson is a big bet, but I think playing him at number 4 is not that utility, what I personally feel, because if someone is getting only 10-12 overs to bat, and he's someone who has always done well for SRS when he's opening the batting, even in one game where he got an injury, he opened and he got quick runs for them.
Yeah.
But I think in the middle order, he's too good a player to be sitting out. I agree to that fact as well. But I feel that if Nabi plays, and Priyam Garg can play at number 4, because it gives him the opportunity to play a few balls in, and then he can adapt to the situation. Playing Priyam Garg in the last 5-6 over doesn't make much of a choice for me. If you want to play Priyam Garg, he has to bat in the top 4. And if he doesn't bat in the top 4, they have to go with Abdul Samad.
Alright. Ritikda, what are your take on it?
Yeah, that's a great point. Raman summed it up really well, I must say, you know, weighing all the options. I'm also not a big fan of someone like Kane Williamson, who is a conventional batsman. If he has time to settle down, he can really control the innings and, you know, people can bat around him. And if he's there till the end, he can, you know, play his shots. He's played good innings for New Zealand and his IPL franchise whenever he has had time. Same applies to someone like Priyam. I've played with him, I've seen him play in first-class cricket. Yeah, so he is also someone very conventional, likes to, take some time and then he can really blossom, you know, express himself if he has some time to settle down. But then again, Manish Pandey is also similar. So, you can't have three batsmen like that batting at 3, 4 and 5. Some might feel Williamson should bat 3, Manish Pandey 4, Priyam 5 or Priyam 4, Manish Pandey 5. But honestly, all these three guys, if you ask me, are suited for the top order in a T20 game because they need their time. I think exactly. I can still imagine Manish batting a little lower down the order, but he's done so well for his IPL franchise at there, which puts Kane Williamson and Priyam at 4 and 5. So, yes, it's a little tough, but I don't think they will make too many changes because they are building momentum behind them. But I've always been a big fan of the way Jason Holder bats. Yeah. And, he brings in a balance, he chips in with the ball, and I think he's a fantastic batsman in all forms of the game, T20, one day, test cricket. So good that he's fitted in well after Mitchell Marsh got injured, unfortunately. So he brings in some impetus. Abdul Samad is a bit of a gamble, but then you need a player like that, you know, on his day he can really win you the game. So yes, after the opening slot, the 3, 4 and 5 may not be ideal, you know, despite these three guys being very good batters. You know, Kane Williamson is a world-class batsman. Manish Pandey is a proven performer in white ball cricket at the highest level also. Priyam is a fantastic young cricketer. So they have to adapt, you know, and do their best. But Jason Holder in the lower middle order, I think, brings in a good, as I said, impetus. And I think they will not make too many chopping and changing because they have wins and they have some momentum going into this knockout phase.
All right. Ritik Da, coming to Sandeep Sharma, you know, do you think that he is the most underrated bowler in IPL in the last few years? Because he has always performed, but he doesn't have that big name. He hasn't earned that big name, but he always deserves that. You know, because he has always done that in the power play. The most, I think, is he just overtook Zahir Khan in the most wickets taken in the power plays. So, what are your take on it, you know, Sandeep Sharma?
Yes, underrated. Yes, because he is not someone who bowls very quick. He is not someone who has a bouncer and a yorker and this and that. He has a yorker, but I mean, at his pace, if you miss a little bit only, it's not his biggest strength. That's what I'm trying to say. If you miss a little bit, you'll be hit out of the park. Sandeep Sharma is just, I think, a fantastic customer. You know, he's got really good control. He can move the ball both ways. He has a good slower ball. He got Rohit Sharma out with the knuckle ball yesterday. And 100 wickets, he's crossed 100 wickets at an economy of less than 8 in a pretty long IPL career. I think he's played over 80 games. I think that's exceptional. And he has, he knows his game well. He knows his strengths well. He revolves his bowling around that. Very smart guy with good control. And yeah, hats off to him for the way he's performed for whatever franchise he's played for. Underrated, yes, but he's kind of like an overachiever, if you ask me. With his potential, people wouldn't think that he would have such an impact. And kudos to him. I think it's great what he has achieved. And I think he still has a long way to go. But yeah, I'm sure he's going to be a key member going into this eliminator for SRH. He's done a fantastic job.
Absolutely. Abhishek Da, similar views?
Definitely. I think if you see the Sunrisers, the way they have done well in the past 3-4 years in the captaincy of Warner, the biggest reason is their bowling. I think if you see, without Bhuvnesh Kumar, they have one of the best bowling, Indian bowling lines, not talking about the foreign bowlers. They have all the Indian bowlers in their ranks. I think Rashid Khan is definitely, but with the quicks you're talking about, they have a different kind of, you know, their varieties in their lineup. Khalil Ahmed, who plays regularly for them, hasn't been playing much. Bhuvnesh is unfit. Still they are winning. Still these guys are winning the games for them. And Sandeep Sharma, if you see his record, you see he gets big wickets like Gale. He's got Kohli 7 times, got Sharma, Rohit Sharma last day. And his economy in the power play is exceptional. When you play cricket for so long, 10-8 years in the IPL, you're bound to get hammered a few times. But he hasn't. He has been the most, you said the word underrated is pretty much right for him. Because he go unnoticed. The performance of his has always gone unnoticed. Now people are seeing his credibility, what he has brings to the table to SRH for so many years now. But he always goes around like that. He give you 4 overs in the power play or outside the power play in the death overs. He will come in, he's do his job and will go back. Nobody will even notice what he has done. But when he gets those big wickets, everybody starts to talk about him. So I think he's getting his rewards now. Pretty late, I may say. He's got over 100 IPL wickets. It's an economy of around 7, which is exceptional. I think it's exceptional.
Yeah,
and even Natarajan has been really good. Raman was talking about exactly. The Indian fast bowlers, so he's been really impressive.
Without doubt.
Exactly.
Absolutely.
And SRH has been brilliant with picking up Indian pace bowlers.
Yeah, absolutely. And even I remember, you know, the 2016 IPL edition when they won. You know, it was Mohammad Siraj and Siddharth Kaur used to bowl the death overs. And David Warner was so brilliant with his captaincy, and he's always been in the IPL. And that is something really, really extraordinary.
Exactly. I think you talk about David Warner. I think he's one of the best cricketing minds around. I think he looks a guy who's very angry. You know, he do a lot of things which are not pretty much suited to a gentleman's game as we talk about cricket. But I think he's one of the guys who plays the cricket. You know, he loves the game. He has a passion for the game. And I think people take it in a wrong way. When you talk about Kohli's captaincy or a Warner's captaincy, we just took it in a wrong way that he's got attitude, he's speaking so much, he's loud mouthed. But I think they walk the talk as well. I think you have to see the kind of passion they have when they're leading their side. I think you see David Warner jumping around, you know, in an IPL game, he has so much of enthusiasm. And that shows, it erupts in the team as well. if a captain, you know, makes some kind of saves on the ground, the way he runs on the ground, the kind of batting while he's batting, the kind of singles he's taking, the way he's pushing around with the partner, I think it's amazing. I think the kind of attitude that guy has, it's exceptional. I think it's so much to do with the spirit of the team. It really, really makes the team really, gel together as well.
Okay. Now I'm throwing off a kind of a difficult question for you guys, it goes to both of you. That is, which substitute pair has impressed you guys the more? That is it Ridhiman Shah and David Warner or Ishan Kishan or Deacock? Because in place of Rohit Sharma, Ishan Kishan has jumped in as an opener and for Barishto Saha has jumped in. So which substitute pair has impressed you the most? First of all, Ritikda, what is your take?
Well, I must say that you use the term underrated for Sandeep Sharma. Ridhiman Saha is, I think, an underrated batsman in T20 cricket, especially when he's batting at the top of the order. I know he got his IPL 100 in the finals of 2014 at number 4. That was a once-in-a-lifetime kind of innings. But for Bengal and IPL also, whenever he's opened the batting, he is one of the most effective batters in the power play. Another wicketkeeper that comes to mind is Parthiv Patel. So both these men, I think Parthiv has had way more opportunity than Riddhida to play at the top of the order in the IPL. But Riddhida's batting is, we are aware of it. Unfortunately, he hasn't been given as much exposure in the IPL level at the top of the order because he's fantastic, especially in the power play. And if he gets set after 6 overs also, he's very good. So, it was no surprise to me. I was very eagerly waiting when Sunrisers will let him play at the top of the order because he played one game before this in the middle order, which I thought was unfair, just
very much
one innings and then he was dropped. And then finally, when he got a go at the top of the order, he showed what he can do. 3 matches back to back. So, no surprises for me, but I'm just very happy for him and I'm glad that he got to play at his preferred position. And when it comes to Ishan, once again, someone I've played with and I've seen him over the years, very talented, but I think he's finally coming of age. I have seen now a conscious effort on his part to pace his innings, play according to the situation, showing restraint when it is needed. He still, of course, has, I think, improvement left to do. He knows that. He's worked on his offside game. His temperament is better. His match reading and adapting to situations and playing accordingly is better. So he's really shown signs of coming of age. There has never been any doubt about his potential. And so it's a tough question. I can't really answer. I will always have a soft corner for Ridhida. And so really, really glad that he got to play at the top of the order. And I'm also glad to see someone like Ishan doing more justice to his potential by applying himself better according to the situation and showing restraint and mixing caution with aggression, basically controlled aggression, smart batting. That's what he's doing more of, and he realized that gives him more opportunity to be consistent at the T20 format. He is a smart guy along with being a gifted cricketer, so he's, I think, finally understanding and trying to strike the right balance between caution and aggression and just being smart with how to pace his innings, read situations and conditions and bat accordingly. So both have been super impressive, super subs as you might call them, but equally happy to see both of them bat the way they have.
Yeah, super subs, a wonderful term used. Abhishekda, who has impressed you the most? Saha or Warner?
Definitely both of them, both the options you have given are both are impressive.
Yeah.
But I will go with Ritiman for the sole reason that he wasn't playing. See, Ishan Kishan was playing in the middle order. He was always a pick in the first 11.
Yeah.
He was injured, that's why he didn't start. So, he coming opening is not a difficult thing for him because he's an opener who was batting in the middle order and has got a long run. So, for me, it was not a big change for Ishan Kishan. But someone like Ritiman Saha, who was given only one opportunity in the middle order, and he was made to sit out for next 6-7 matches. And when it's given the chance, it was about qualification. A single game SRS would have lost from there, they wouldn't have qualified. So I think the kind of impetus he has brought in those 3 innings, the kind of, the importance of those 3 innings, top of the order, is immense from my point of view. So I feel that this Ridhiman and Warner has an extra edge when you talk about Deacock and Ishan Kishan. So I definitely feel that Ridhiman Saha's inclusion in the SRH was a bigger plus.